I am a remisier. I execute buy and sell orders in the stock market for clients. I also trade stocks and warrants. I trade structured warrants almost every day. Well, I used to be a warrant market maker, so I understand warrants not only from a retail point of view, but also from an issuer's point of view. I saw opportunities in trading warrants, so I decided to make the switch. Warrants are great for trading due to their low price, which means I incur less trading costs. If I trade shares directly, due to their higher prices, my trading costs will be much higher. So trading a warrant which tracks the movements in blue chip names, yet costs only a few cents, is the logical way to go. Also, warrants move in much greater percentages than the mother shares, so I can magnify my returns with just a small movement in the stock. I used to call the warrant desk to get guidance on the warrant's pricing, but with the new life matrix, it is now very easy. I will log on to Macquarie's website, look up the warrants, and I can see exactly where the market maker's quotes will be at different levels of the stock. I tend to only day trade, so I prefer warrants with higher gearing. Start by observing how the warrant prices move with respect to the underlying. For example, using the life matrix, you can see how a DBS warrant tends to move one tick with every two ticks in the stock. The life matrix can also show you whether a warrant is on a tight spread, which sometimes shows whether the issuer is keen to sell those warrants. If you would like to hold the warrants for more than a day, have a look at the effective gearing to roughly work out what returns you can expect. For example, if you choose a DBS warrant with 10 times effective gearing, it basically means when DBS moves 2%, you can expect the warrant to move 20%. Finally, if you have any questions on the warrants, just call the warrant desk.